Welcome to our Power BI and Power Automate tutorial. Today, we will create this dashboard to monitor sales and profit data. However, we need to report the data to our top management through email as well. And instead of writing email every day or every time they ask for update, we will create a button which will automatically send the email with latest numbers. So, let's begin our tutorial now. In Power BI, create a new report. Click on the Excel workbook to load data from MS Excel file. Click on the Open button to load data into the Power BI report. Select the sheet in the Navigator window and click on the Load button. Once the data is loaded, it will appear in the data pane in the right corner of the application. You can use the text box visual to create a title for your dashboard. Place it at the top of the dashboard and type an appropriate title. Change the font size and style from Format Pane. Drag the sales field to the dashboard. This will create a total sales card visual. Place it at the top left corner. Turn on visual borders and rounded corners for this visual. Change the title of sales field to sales. Make a copy of the sales card and place it at the top right corner next to the sales card. Now, replace the sales field with the profit field and rename it to profit. Finally, add a line and column chart to your dashboard and place it at the bottom of the dashboard. Add the sales field to the column y-axis of the line and column chart, and the profit field to the line y-axis. Add the date field to the x-axis of the chart. Remove unnecessary information such as year and quarter. Turn on visual borders and rounded corners for this visual for better appearance. We are now done with our dashboard. We can now monitor sales and profit on daily basis. However, we need to report the data to our top management through email as well. And instead of writing email every day or every time they ask for update, we will create a button which will automatically send the email with latest numbers. To do that, we will add Power Automate visual to our dashboard. For now, we can place it anywhere on our dashboard. Add the sales and profit fields to this visual, aggregated by sum, and rename them to total sales and total profit. Find these three dots and click on them. They may be above or below the visual, depending upon its location. Now, click on the Edit button. Wait for Flow's screen to load, which we will use to create a flow. There are various templates here, which you can use to create a flow. However, we will use Instant Cloud Flow to create a flow for ourselves. Again, wait for this screen to load. Here, button clicked trigger has been already added. This is the default trigger, and it starts the flow when someone clicks on the button. We will also use this trigger for our flow. Click on the New Step button to add the stuff you want to happen after the button has been clicked. You will find a lot of predefined operations here, which you can select and customize for your flow. Type email in the search box to find email-related actions. We want to send an email, therefore, select the Send an Email action. This will open a new screen where you can define stuff such as recipient, subject, and body of the email. Let's enter our Gmail address in the recipient field and enter sales and profit in the subject field. Type an appropriate message in the body. Select the location where you want to enter the sales. Simply click on the total sales parameter and it will be added to the location. As soon as the parameter is added, the send an email action will be wrapped inside A for each container. Now select the location where you want to enter the amount of profit and click on the total profit parameter. Now we have both sales and profit in our email report. Save and apply the flow. Once the flow is saved, click on the back button to go back to the previous screen. Here you will find important information about the flow, including the number of times it has been run and status. Do not run the flow from here, it may result in errors. Go back to the dashboard and run the flow through the Power Automate button. Place the button on top right corner of the dashboard. Turn on visual borders and rounded corners to match it with the rest of the visuals. While pressing the control key, click on this button to run the flow and send the automated email message. Wait for the button text to turn into triggered. Now it shows that the flow has been completed, which means that the email has been sent. Let's go to our Gmail account and check the email. The email has been received. Let's open the email and check if it contains the data. The email contains both sales and profit data, just as we desired. Now, let's go back to the dashboard. Edit the Power Automate button. Find the three dots, click on them, and then click on the Edit. Let the screen load. Once loaded, click on the flow and edit it. Again, let the screen load. Go back to the previous screen. And here you can now see the detail of flow when it was run last time, including its status. If your flow fails to run, you will find the details here, including the description of error. Now, let's go back to the dashboard. Add the date field to the Power Automate visual. Change it to date from date hierarchy. Then, in the summarize menu, change it to latest. Now this will show the latest date. Edit the Power Automate visual. Select the send an email flow and edit it as well. Expand the container and then send an email action. Let's add the latest date to the subject of the email to clearly report the date to the management, pertaining to the sales and profit numbers being reported in the message. Save and apply the flow and go back to the dashboard. Now, run the flow by clicking on the button while pressing the control key. Once the text is turned into triggered, we can go and check the email. Let's check the email by refreshing the inbox. And here is the email sent from Power BI. And clearly, it contains the latest date in its subject. We can also format data taken from Power BI. Let's copy the date from subject. And edit the Power Automate visual. Edit the flow. Expand the container and send a mail action. Previously, we simply inserted the parameters from the list without formatting. This time, let's also format the parameters before adding them to our email. To do that, click on the Select parameter, then select the parameter, and then enter the example formatting. Enter your desired formatting here to convert the default format into your desired format. You can add multiple examples here. And then click on the Get Expression button to convert them into an expression. After creating the expression, click on the Apply button to apply the expression. You can delete the old parameter now to display only the formatted one. Now, let's add the sales amount with proper format. Just like before, we will create an example where we will enter our desired format to convert the default value into our desired format. Click on Apply button to add the formatted parameter. And in the same way, replace the amount of profit as well with the formatted parameter. Now we can save the send an email action and the flow as well. After saving, go back to the dashboard and try to send the email again. Now, let's go to our inbox and see if the email has been sent or not. We have received the email, and the date in the subject is formatted exactly as we wished. The amounts of sales and profit in the message are also properly formatted now. And with this, we end our tutorial. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.